I am Massimo Zollo, Director of the Studies of the article published on Brain Issue, the 27th of February 2018. This article is dealing with the mechanistic studies and the functional definitions of genes that are involved with metastatic process of group 3 medulloblastoma. Medulloblastoma is a tumor occurring in cerebellum, and it is known that it is divided in four main molecular signatures, of which group 3, group 4, and sonic are the main metastatic tumors. The latest three groups are developing spinal and vertebral metastasis, and this is the major event of, unfortunately, death of these young patients. In this manuscript, we define how the metastasis is occurring in group 3 medulloblastoma by dissecting several signaling pathways, mainly involved with the TGF-beta regulation and OTX2 overexpression and downregulation of the suppressor oncosuppressor PTEN. We have here in the paper additional information regarding how this is happening, and we have finally defined a drug that is able to impair this mechanism. And the use of this small molecule was tested in vivo in xenograft studies in animals, where we use group 3 medulloblastoma tumor cell lines, actually medullospheres, which are generating the metastatic process, and we use the drug to impair this phenomenon in vivo.
Here we describe the anti-metastatic action of an anti-PRUN1 drug, AA71, in vivo using cerebellar tumor tissue derived from the treated mice. We demonstrate the ability of the drug to enhance the degradation of PRUN1, OTX2, and to upregulate the tumor suppressor PTEN. This drug acts by inhibiting the canonical TGF-beta pathway and the epithelial mesenchymal transition processes with E-cadherin increase and N-cadherin loss. Finally, we also show the ability of the drug to inhibit the tumor stemness properties and to enhance the pro-differentiation processes.
So this phenomenon is driven by epithelial mesenchymal transition, and we have shown that the use of the drug impairs this signaling. Another important information is that now we have a way of understanding what are the genes that will develop later on metastasis. And what we have done for the first time is to sequence the medulloSPHEres of this group 3 patients. And we finally put together the data of three VUL medulloSPHEres sequenced by next generation sequencing, and we identify 23 single nucleotide variation mutation that are occurring during the metastatic processes. Of this, I think what is the major important finding is that we found genes with function related to myeloid derived suppressor cells function and natural killer activity and actually cytotoxicity. So this is very important because these tumors now are in the way of going with therapies, potentially with immunotherapy. And so we have to take in high consideration our finding because of this mutation occurring on these medulloSPHEres of group 3 tumors. What is very important here is even to discuss how the team was put together. We had the chemist, we had a translational oncology team, and we had the surgeon that are doing the neuro surgery on this young patient.
Collaboration between the surgeon and the geneticians is very important in the timing in order to have a genetician or a person of the laboratory ready into the operating room, and for the surgeon to be able to collect the best possible sample of the tumor without previous coagulation and without previous manipulation in order to have no artifact related to the surgical procedure.
I'm very happy that this research was done in Naples here at Change, and proud of this team and this fascinating work.